the best low cost here as well. AirAsia number one in the world, 9 years already. So we talk about. So today we will talk about flights, about how to get cheap or even free flights, accommodations, tours and excursions, and what else? How to travel with kids? Nobody interested, they say. Adult travel. So about what else? Yeah, basically many about couch surfing as well, right? So what I start with why. Question why is very important. Why we have to travel, right? Travel it's itself for me and for my kids and for everyone, I believe it's self-developing itself, right? When you travel, you're always out of comfort zone, right? So it's always when you're out of comfort zone, it's always self-developing, agree, right? So it's open up your mind. It's the best way to open your mind out of box, you know, out of stereotypes, right? So and yeah, my friend, she has a radio blog, and she say that her blog name, Travel Save the World. It's true. It's like closed mind people, they stay in their village and they see the world differently, right? So those who travel. And what I like, my favorite quotes, the world is a book, and those who do not travel, read just one page. Read only one page, right? So it's Mark Twain. Another one, he say, only two things we regret on a deathbed, that we are little loved and little travel, right? Agree. So that's why I believe that everyone can travel. Does not matter how much income you have, how much like money you have. Usually like this, we have a lot of money and little time, or a lot of time and little money. So actually in this life we have to choose, we have to find a balance, right? So when I come 8 years to Malaysia, 8 years back, I have a lot of time and little money, but it's never stopped me. So actually this book changed my life, Practice Guide of Free Travel. Free travel is something like, not free, but freedom. Start like, you know, it's my friend, he wrote this book, Anton Krotov, and we became friends after, like, I read this book, I get inspired, I start to travel, and he's author of many books. And in Russia we have 5 hitchhiking school. So basically I told you, I come with $2 budget only for food, I come by hitchhiking. So sometimes I use train without tickets. So when I travel, good. My quotes is, now I travel many styles, by bicycle, by walk, with money, without money, almost without money. So the idea is less money, more adventure, more fun, more interaction with the world. So I feel like this year I'm gonna try Santiago de Compostela walk without using any money and any internet. It will be extreme one. Who want to join, let me know.
It's a lovely walk.
Santiago.
Yes, but we will see how I survive.
Santiago, if
Spanish
is in Chile.
People. No, Spain.
Spanish pilgrimage, yeah. So travel also increase your creativity. Especially if you travel with little money, more creativity you have. So like me, with $2, I managed to go every places which tourists pay normally a lot of money. I always managed to, different way I found to go for free. So if you have money to pay, it's fine. But sometimes, so what I want to say as well, important to understand the philosophy, right? The money is just one kind of energy. There are many energy to exchange, right? So hitchhiking philosophy is when you it's environmental friendly, you don't use your car, you use someone else's car, and the driver is often fell asleep, so you save driver's life from falling asleep and have accident. Also you sometimes feel like not talking but listening, and it's good, you work as a psychotherapist, yeah, like let driver talk. So it's in many ways it's really great. And for example, like train or bus, like you buy a ticket, but this one, hitchhiking or kind of style, less budget, it's make you really interact very, very close to to people, to local people. For example, your driver could be a general army and he can bring you to the place where tourists never been, like it's happened with me, never been before. And it's not allowed for foreigner, it's that punishment for foreigner to go. So you cover up your face, like pretend you're local, or even you hide in a car somewhere and you discover some, you know, which is place cannot be discovered at all, right? So this brings you a lot of opportunity, right? So, yeah. Yeah, this book actually free to download in Amazon and internet. I really, it's life-changing, I believe, not only for me. A practical guide for free travelers. Yeah, it's in English. Originally it's in Russian. So it's in many languages now, in French, in Polish, in many languages. And it's free to download and it's just 100 pages. It's like, it's just like a couple of hours to read. And it will bring you some beautiful ideas. So yeah, I advise you to download. Even apps, they have apps. So yeah, and let's start with yeah. Let's yeah. We have like 1 hour maybe, right? Yeah. So let's start with maybe. Also, I'm going to talk about most useful website for independent traveler. Well, let's differentiate traveler and tourist. Tourist is those who buying the package, who pay, and they just, how to say, tuleница, Lilia, Sergey, where are my friends for translation? I don't see them. Okay, so it's like you just doing nothing in a tourist reservation. Like,
luxury,
you know,
luxury.
It's like vegetable life. Like, and traveler, real traveler, is someone who really come to the country to discover, right? To know the people, to go deep in the culture, right? So it's different type, you understand, right? So, like, I'm talking about real traveler stuff today, right? So, yeah, even my friend, they have a blog and they create this term, travel living, life on a travel living, one word, right? So nowadays, 21st century, everyone working online, many people, right? So digital nomads, freelance, right? Doesn't matter where you are geographically, right? You travel around the world, so you not necessarily stick to one place, right? And it's wonderful, I found this wonderful. So, yeah. And especially if you're a blogger or photographer or some creative person who doing like blogs or Instagram or Facebook, and you are, you have lots of followers, or maybe later you will have, because so it's always how to say, is a way to travel and get stuff for free, right? Or discounts, because even in KL Bird Park, you come and you say, I'm a blogger, you know, and they will give you, probably they'll give you for free, because they know the marketing and advertising is very important, right, nowadays. So it's good to not only travel, but to share your travel with others, right? In Instagram, social networks, blogs, whatever. So that's what I do also. Travel with kids, we skip these two pages. Somebody who interested, I'll tell you later personally. Mm-hmm. Also one topic I want to talk later, how to make money on the ways, because I'm used to do it. Today gathering is also for your contribution, you mentioned or not. So let's start about flights. Flight search is very important. Usually we start travel with searching for flights, right? So we choose the country, we choose the destinations, and the best way is, we have AirAsia here, right? We have Malindo here, somebody mentioned already. In Southeast Asia we have Lion, Tiger. Tiger is based in Singapore, Lion based in Indonesia, Cebu Pacific based in Philippines, Nok Air Thailand, easyjet Vietnam, SpiceJet India. So there are many more, yeah. But the things about low cost generally is, if you want luggage, you pay extra. If you want food, you pay extra. Like if you are a real traveler and you can make it in 7 or 10 kilo bags and bring inside, and yeah, it's, you don't have to pay extra, I mean, understand, right? And bring your food. So, and in Europe they have beautiful also many low cost, which is most famous, Ryanair, easyjet, wizzair, Norwegian. So maybe we have a group on WhatsApp, I will share with you some most useful website I will mention today, right?
The new one in Singapore launches, Scoot.
S-C-O-O-T.
I heard it. Yeah, they are very small, but yes. Hopefully, yeah, hopefully. Because the best things to have many low-cost airline is their concurrence and they make it price even better, right? So, yeah. In Russia we have Pobeda. Oh, horrible, but low cost. Yeah. You know what? My friends, the Russians, stay in Italy, based in Italy. They made first and last. Well, nobody made another one yet. Human power search for flights. Human power flight search, they call it. So very important website, Flystein. It's like Einstein, but Flystein. Understand, right? So for those who travel smart. So the idea is very simple. Idea is you actually. We are like, I'm in the tourism 8 years, but if you are not in the tourism, you actually spend a lot of energy and time to find cheap flight, but you actually not find the cheapest option, right? These guys, they'll find you the best option, maybe 2 times less than you found. And what you have to do is just to give them as a contribution, maybe 5-10%, depending on your flight, on the distance, understand, right? It's really great deal, so I really recommend their website, Flystein. So I will
put
maybe write you.
Like
yeah, I will put, but yeah, get notice if you have chance, right? So, for example, what I saw today on their website, San Francisco, Boston, $29, Paris, Boston, two ways, round trip. $49 Paris, Boston, New York, London, $49 as well. So it's really, it's round trip. It's really amazing. And business class, London, New York, from 95. Imagine that. So why? Because of the error, how to say, on the system, right? They found this error and they use it. I mean, you know, we talk about this now, right? Yeah, another very useful website. I will mention few who always, there are system when we search, there are some mistake errors, they call it errors, right? So, and what can happen? You buy fantastic cheap flight, which is cannot be even, you know, so you bought it and it's company mistake. And what they can do, they can return your money back, or maybe they will not. Maybe you will lucky to get this flight, right? There is always 50-50, right? But it's nice to buy anyway. So, yeah, these sites, Flyer Talk, for example, for flyertalk.com, secretflying.com. Yeah, this is those websites who put together all these errors and, you know, news and promos. Yeah, so it's very, very good. You don't have to search it by yourself, right? So
can we get all the websites later?
Yes, I will.
No, she just put it on our potluck group.
Yes, I will
put it on
yeah.
The potluck group.
Yeah, and also when we do flight search, we use several platform, right? Skyscanner, you heard like Malindo, right? So let's talk about Skyscanner is good because you can see the flights in 1 week, in 1 month, how price changed, right? So I like Skyscanner. And Malindo is good because it automatically include the nearby airports in the system. So let's say it's cheaper to go from city, which is just few distance, not so far, right? So, and Aviasales is a Russian one, but they have English version. It's good because not actually all flight search included low-cost airlines. So most of the flight search, they try to avoid low-cost, but Aviasales, they include and it's really good. So, yeah, and I mentioned two more websites, Traveloka, Roo Pirates, some of them Russian, but you always can translate button, you can always use it, and it's fine, because Russian, we really interested in budget traveling, yeah? 5 hitch-hiking school in each city, Moscow, St. Petersburg, so we really, yeah.
So they really teach you
well.
How to yeah. Hitchhike.
What and about destinations?
Yes, wait, another moment. For example, me, I'm based in Malaysia, and I every year I go to Europe, to Russia, right? So what I have to do, and you have to do, also choose the airline you most interesting, most useful for you, for your destination, like Qatar or Emirates or Better Tours, and subscribe their special promo to your email, right? Because what's happened, how they do? They usually have a certain promo, like Qatar, once a year they have kids travel for free, which is a lot of saving, right? So kids travel for free, and they put to your email in 4 days. Only subscriber get this information, not all the users, right? And after 4 days, you have these 4 days to book this travel with kids for free, or maybe 50%, depend. And after that, it's open to public, to everyone, and in 1 day, tickets is finished, right? So it's very, very useful. I suggest you, especially like Emirates, like Singapore Airlines, they have nice promo as well, and those just, it's very easy button to click and put your email, so you will get all the news, right? So, for example, about Singaporean airline, Moscow, Singapore, Moscow, round trip, $400. And Singapore, Moscow, Singapore, the same date, $800, 2 times more. So in this case, I better ask my mom to come here. It's 2 times cheaper than I travel to Russia, right? So, yeah, and also, as a Malaysian passport holder, I think it's not a problem for you, but for me, sometimes, like in US, in Australia, in New Zealand, they don't have a transit zone. If you travel as a transit, they don't have a transit zone, so you have to get visa. It's a transit visa. So you have to be really careful, I mean, when you just use country as transit, right? Yeah,
Canada but has this problem.
Yes, yes. So many people, they don't know it, but they bought the ticket and they're not even allowed to go to the plane, because normally airline, they don't want to go in you to the plane, because after that they have to pay for your return, right?
Yes.
So be careful with, not all the airports have transit zone. So, yeah, basically, also because we are based in Malaysia, the website ticket, but not English spelling, but Malaysian spelling ticket, it's about Indonesian and Southeast Asian low cost, it's best prices as well. So, yeah. And actually this year, maybe World Cup football, it's in Russia.
In Russia.
And it's visa-free.
This is very important.
Yeah, yes. It's very important news, yeah. Those who travel to Russia, it's very difficult to get visa, very, how to say, headache with the papers, how they call it, bureaucracy, so much, yes, bureaucracy, yes. Still. But this year, if you just buy a ticket to football, which is $100, you will get public transport for free, visa free.
Ticket $100?
Yeah, $100 ticket. Yeah.
So buy which ticket? The match ticket or the airline?
Your ticket or the airline?
No, match ticket. Match ticket $100.
Match ticket,
yes.
$100.
But you know, the visa cost $200, something
so
like
no
that.
No need visa.
Yeah, but this ticket, it save you, I mean, on visa, on your energy, on papers preparation.
Fantastic.
So, yeah, if you want to go to Russia, ask me later, I mean, and I will, I will tell you more how to come to Russia. So how about accommodation? Let's talk about accommodation. The best way to travel for real traveler is to stay with locals, right? How to stay with locals? It's actually free. In Malaysia, if we see couch surfing, it's a big travel network. Some of you may be members already. We host with my husband. I meet my husband through couch surfing, by the way.
Yes.
We host more than 1,000 people in 8 years. Sometimes the most big number we have in 1 day, 20 people. So, normally we have 5-10 people. We have big apartments, we have few apartments, but in one apartment we host 20 people once.
Wow.
So, and we host 3 months baby, we host 80 years lady. So different age, different. And I want to inspire you to become a good host, more hospitable, because it's really, really beautiful. My experience, I tell you just about my experience. So I host 1,000 people in my profile, like more than 200 reference, and my husband profile also more than 200 reference. It's a reference system, it's like social network, who most of you know couch surfing, right?
Yes.
So you open your doors for a stranger, but about this stranger, you know the general information, you see the photo, you know the job. So many beautiful people stay with me. Example, Anton Krotov, the writer of this book, many times, all the time he's in Southeast Asia, he stay with me. Niesin, it's another Russian writer. Ernest Zakharievich, who draw half of the Penang, the street art of,
yes,
Penang, the artist, he stay with me. First he come to Malaysia and he wasn't famous. The first days he spent in my house, yeah. Another guy, Tony Gillis, it's an English writer, he born blind and he partly deaf, and kidney transplant. So such a, how to say, such a health condition, not so good, but he traveled and he ride more than 150 countries already. Malaysia was number 100 country for him, and he organized for him motivation talk. He's really good guy. So another Spanish writer stay with me, Iranian film director. So I feel like best people, the creative bohema, the artist, musician, photographers, journalists, best anthropologists, scientists, they all come to my house and they come to KL, they all stay with me. So you feel it, you always learn a lot from your guests, right? And actually for me it's like relationship, friendship is the most important in life. It's like money or something, status, you can't bring to graveyard or to next life, right? But the friendship really open your mind, you know, new people coming to you. So, and in Russia we say, do not have 100 rubles, but have 100 friends. So, and couch surfing, as I'm using for 8 years, and 1,000 people we host, everywhere I go now, in any city and planet, in any, how to say, country, almost everywhere I have a people who know me, who welcome me, and it's beautiful, you know, like get locals. And in couch surfing, if you, let's say in your apartment, you don't have a space to host like people, or maybe like you feel not comfortable, some people introverts, they want to be by themselves, right? You can always participate, coffee or drink status. It means meet someone, for example, you want to practice Spanish, like I'm going to Spain, I want to practice Spanish, and I don't have, in my city when I stay before, I rent a room, I have not much space to, you know, to offer my room. So I, coffee or drink, so you meet person and you talk and you feel this person is good, you have little time, you show your favorite places in KL, for example, or wherever you are, right? So it's really, really a good way. And actually, yeah, free accommodation, couchsurfing, it could be used as a free accommodation if in free food, not free food sometimes they offer, right? Some good hosts, especially in Malaysia, right? Offer, and free guide, I mean, you get local guide, right? Who really knows the places, right? So. It's really
in Kuala Lumpur every Wednesday and every Friday is couch surfing night where all the travelers meet up in KL.
Yes. I advise you to go at least once.
I've been there before.
Mm-hmm. Couch surfing is really good. So it's spoiled because it became a little bit commercial and stuff, but still we can close eyes on it. It's fine. So yeah, and you know what? I surprisingly discovered I have 2 kids now, 2 years and 5 years old, and it's perfectly work with kids. When you travel with kids, you got host even faster. Even I send the request and I don't expect people, you know, welcome me with kids. And they do in 5 minutes. They say, yes, welcome Olga. And I say, you answer in 5 minutes, how come? And they say, because you're with kids. So the people willing to help you more and, you know, welcoming you more. People actually love kids.
This is your baby, it's a celebrity.
Yeah, could be.
Trust issues.
Yeah, it's actually a trust issue.
Yes, that's
trust
true,
issue,
that's true, yeah.
Family,
you can call it like that.
Person.
And in many Asian countries, especially in Africa as well, the guest treated as like God sent the guest, right? So they treat you as a really like an angel. Actually, my experience, my couch surfer guests are my angel. I use half year I travel, so people welcome me everywhere. So, and half year I receive the guest, and it's like always angel. For example, I think like, oh, I need actually photographer because my husband photographer, but he always out of camera. So next 5 minutes I get the request, Olga, we are photographers, could you host us and we can make photo for